you told in one place that angels do not have free will, but somewhere in Quran I read in Al-Bahra I read that Iblis was not willing to bow down to Adam when Allah told. So that is his free will. He took it like that.
MashaAllah. Our brother Vivek is very learned. He read the Quran, MashaAllah. Our brother Vivek has read the Quran. And I do agree with him, Surah Baqarah. He's quoting the verse of the Quran from Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 38, 39, 40. He says, we told to the angels bow down, all bow down except Iblis. This is mentioned not only in Surah Baqarah, it is mentioned minimum 7 times in the Quran. In Surah Araf, in Surah chapter number 7, Surah Hijr chapter number 15, Surah Qahaf chapter number 16, Surah Sajda chapter number 32. Same thing. We told to the angels bow down, all bow down except Iblis. So now Iblis objected. So from this we come to know that Iblis, if we read the translation, we understand Iblis for the angel. We think. But if you read in Surah Qahaf chapter number 18, verse number 50, it says that we asked to the angels bow down, all bowed down except Iblis. Iblis was amongst the jinn. You understand? So Iblis was a jinn. So now you tell me, brother Zakir, 7 places it says that all Allah said to the angels, bow down, all bow down except Iblis, means angel. Now one place in the Quran says he was a jinn. So there's a contradiction. Correct? It's a contradiction because this is the translation. In Arabic language, there is a law called as law of taglib. Taglib means if the majority is addressed, the minority need not be addressed. For example, if there are 99 doctors and one engineer, and if I say all doctors stand up, even that engineer will stand up. Because in the law of taglib, in Arabic grammar, the majority is addressed, minority is addressed. I need not say all doctors and one engineer stand up. But in English language, if I say all doctors stand up, only doctors will stand up, that one engineer will not stand. So nowhere does the Quran say that Iblis was an angel, nowhere. We, because of the translation and lack of Arabic knowledge, we think it as we assume. Many of the Muslims also assume. But the Quran clarifies in Surah Qahaf chapter 18 verse number 50 that Iblis was a jinn. And jinn, like the human beings, have a free will. So amongst the angels, there was one jinn also present who was Iblis. He was very pious. But his arrogance, that why should I bow down to Adam? He's made from mud. I'm made from fire. Arrogance. That didn't made him disobey Almighty God. He was a jinn. Even human beings and jinn both have a free will. They can disobey God. So here they disobey God. And that's the reason he was taken out. And he is the biggest Satan. And now he tries to attract the people who are on the path of God and try to distract them from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I hope that answers the question.